So, I did our laundry, like I always do on Sundays, and in the middle of folding our bedspread, I noticed your jock strap in the washing machine. Yeah, it was drowning in the wash cycle. It was twisting and turning and being mangled and manipulated in all sorts of painful positions. And then the strangest thing, I imagined you were still in it. And in the jock strap, I mean. I got hysterical. I mean, I couldn't stop laughing. I thought, this is the funniest thing I ever thought of. People started staring at me, actually. A woman came up to me and said, to be careful not to inhale too much of the fabric softener. And then all of a sudden, I heard your voice. So I ran off to the machine. I lifted the lid, and I could hear you in there, choking on the Clorox 2 and the lemon fab. But I couldn't make out what you were saying, so I yelled, Frank, what is it? What are you saying? And the manager of the laundromat yelled back, I'm gonna call the police if you don't stop screaming at your wash, lady. It made me think, Frank, it made me think that maybe I'm not handling this too well. I mean, I can't drop 2 years of being friends, of being lovers, and then go back to being friends. We never were friends, Frank. We slept together on the first date, remember? And I know you wanted to leave on good terms, like telling me you still love me and all, but I really think it will be easier for me if we just break up as enemies. It would be much better for me just to hate you openly instead of being so adult about all of this. I mean, why being adult about all of this? So you can tell me about your lover, I can tell you about my lovers, so we can sleep together for good old time's sake. I don't want to be your friend, Frank. I love you, but I never said I liked you. And if being friends and being adult means throwing me away for that slut rag you picked up at the goddamn train platform, well, then the most mature thing I could do for you would be to rip your face off. Oh yeah, that feels much better. Thank you.